I colored it purple underneath the line art layers so that I don't miss a spot when coloring. And then I used the quick selection tool to select the parts that I want to color. Create a new layer above the purple or the base layer and fill it using black. This way, it's easy to see the missing spots when you're coloring. Click on the Lock Transparent Pixels on the Layers tab so you can easily edit the contents or the paint on that layer. I can easily change the color of her skin. Here's a tip for organizing your layers. Label them. This labels your selected layer with the color of your choice. This can help your workflow in managing layers. As you can see, I labeled Rova's layers yellow and Rune's layers violet. Here's a more efficient way in using the selection tool. Go to Select, Modify, and then Expand. I usually expand them by 2 pixels. What this does is that it expands your selection by how many pixels you want. This is a more efficient way in selecting parts that you want to color, so you have a smaller portion to clean up. Another tip in speeding up your workflow is that you can jump to different layers by using the Move tool. In this part, I decided to use a different color than black to easily spot the messy mistakes. Clipping mask for your shading layer. Create a layer above the base color layer that you want to shade and select Create Clipping Mask. This means you can only color or paint based on the layer below that new layer. Brushing your shading layer. Basically, create a gradient on the previous cell shading layer, or any layer, using the soft round brush to make it look more detailed. I usually blend the cell shading using an airbrush to make a softer look. time to color the line art. Group all the line art layers and then create a new layer above it. And on that new layer, right-click and create clipping mask. This way, you can freely color or paint over your line art layers. Another way to do this is by creating a new adjustment layer. Don't forget to check the box underneath the name. Afterwards, a hue saturation window will appear. Check the colorize box, and then you can freely change the line art color. I usually color certain parts of my line art. I create a new layer above the hue saturation layer. I right-click it, and then I create clipping mask. This is a good way to add more details on your line art so that it doesn't look too boring. Because I'm a perfectionist that likes to add a lot of details, I usually airbrush my line art to create more depth. Create a separate layer and use the airbrush to create a soft gradient. This makes your line art doesn't look too flat. Once I'm done with the drawing, I usually create an outer stroke. Group all the layers, including the line art and the color layers. Double-click it to open the layer style. Pick stroke. Make sure the position is outside. And then you can determine the size, the blending mode, the opacity, and of course the color of the stroke. Creating an outer stroke is also a great way to clean up the colors that are outside the line art. As you can see from the messy outer stroke, this means that some of the colors underneath the line art are outside the line art.